Not the way that it sounded. I know you're not a witch.
Of course. And I know you're not Snow White.
I may have to wait hours before I read. Probably starve to death before their eyes.
I'm going to get them, aren't you?
What makes you so sure?
Well, you're a very pretty girl. And that's what they want in theater, isn't it?
Well, now you have to have more than just a pretty face. Anyway, I'm not really pretty. I think I'm interesting looking, and in certain lights I can look sort of lovely, but I'm not pretty.
Nonsense. You're extremely pretty.
No, I'm not.
Yes, you are.
No, I'm not. I've got beady little eyes like a bird and a figure like a potus. Well? Aren't you going to deny that you said that?
How can I, dear? Obviously, you heard it.
There are plenty of true things you can put me down with. You don't have to put me down with lies.
You know what I like about you?
Nothing.
Oh, yes. I like your honesty, your candor. You really are part of the women, aren't you, Mrs. Benson?
Well, I suppose I am. I really wish you wouldn't call me Mrs. Benson.
That's her name, isn't it, Mrs. Benson?
You don't say it as though you mean it.
I'm sorry. Why don't I call you Jill? That's more friendly. And I'll try to say it as though I mean it. Now, Jill. I was wondering if anyone you and I might have in common. He likes you.
Very much.
And I like him very much.
He may very well be the most beautiful person I've ever met. Just imagine going through life, not seeing anything. Not a painting or a flower. Not even a Christmas card. I want to die. But Donnie wants to live. And I mean really live. Then, and he can even kid about it. He's fantastic.
Then you would want what's best for him, wouldn't you?
Oh, now we're getting to it, aren't we? Like, maybe I should be able to go home with you. Is that it?
Donnie was happy at home with Linda Fletcher for little ideas about a place of his own.
Maybe you just want to believe that he can only be happy with you, Mrs. Baker. Well, they're not so blind as those who will not see. There, I can quote Dylan Thomas and little Donnie Dark.
You constantly astonish me.
Well, we women of the world do that.
Don
to live wherever he wants to. And he's not alone. I'm here.
For how long? Have you got a lease on that apartment?
No.
So you could leave tomorrow if you felt like it.
That's right.
You couldn't sustain a marriage for 6 days, could you?
My marriage doesn't concern you.
Didn't concern you much either, did it?
Yes, it did!
Have you ever learned marriage to a blind boy might be like? You've seen Donnie at his best in this room, which he's memorized, and he's memorized how many steps to the drugstore and to the bakery. But take him out of this room or off the street, he's lost. He panics. Donnie needs someone who will stay with him, and not just for 6 days.
You can stop worrying, Mrs. Baker. Nothing serious will develop between Donnie and me. I'm not built that way.
But Donnie is built that way.
Oh, please, we're just having kicks.
Kicks? That's how I started Linda. Just kicks. But Donnie fell in love with her, and she fell in love with you. Then what happens?
I don't know.
And stop now before you hurt him.
What about you? Aren't you hurting him?
I can't. I can only irritate him. You can hurt him. The longer you stay, the harder it will be for him. Go have your kicks with someone who won't feel them after he's gone.
I'm not so sure you can't hurt him, Mrs. Baker. Maybe more than anybody. I think you deserve all the credit you can get for bringing up a pretty marvelous guy, for bringing up a son, even a blind one, isn't a lifetime occupation. Now the more you help him, the more you hurt him. It was Linda Fletcher, not you, who gave him the thing that he needed the most, confidence in himself. You're always dwelling on the negative. Always what he needs and never what he wants. Always what he can't do, but never what he can. What about his music? Have you ever heard the song that he wrote? I'll bet you didn't even know he could write songs. You're probably dead right about me. I'm not the ideal girl for him. But I know one thing. Neither are you. If I'm going to tell anybody to go home, it'll be you, Mrs. Baker. You go home.